Celia, you ready?
That's fine. So let's cover off your grants.
Okay, so just a second.
Yeah.
And Celia, and I don't think we can have a formal meeting.
Oh, no, we have to go on.
Work session, is that?
Yeah, a work session or something. And I have no minutes anyway, so that's off the table. So, this one, this is what we're submitting to Dick's Sporting Goods.
Okay.
They want an explanation of our program. That's the little write-up about it. This is the actual application, which is really hard to read. That's why I had that. It has to be confined to 150 words.
Okay.
It's like 145 right now.
All right.
So, this is the Dick's application. And it would go, it's very hard to see, but it went to you guys in an email. It's going to go with this letter. The explanation of our program is what Dan's looking over right now. And the select board is okay with us submitting this to Dick's via the online process. And we're asking them for $250 to support programming as our first choice. And then equipment donation up to $600, which would get us goalposts or nets for the
mm-hmm.
soccer goals, or a couple of volleyball nets, or some bases for the baseball field,
mm-hmm.
or some kickballs, or whatever.
I was up there with some the other day. I'm surprised they don't have bases. Just maybe they do in one of those sheds. I don't know.
And then our third choice would be a gift card to go and buy whatever
mm-hmm.
we want. That's what we're asking them for.
But this here is just. It's not, you're not getting into the specifics of what we would use the money for. It's just the basics of the program is what we're looking to do with this.
I'm looking for the questions. Please describe why your opportunity should be considered. So should we go further into depth?
Maybe even at the very end we could. Let me see if I can kind of rewrite it and kind of scale it back a little, and then
yeah.
you can always add in some specifics at the very end.
Oh, man. That's funny.
So
we have an option of A, B, C.
A, B, C with that one.
Okay. And will they'll determine?
They determine.
If they get a grant, they'll determine which one.
Yeah.
Okay.
With us applying for that they told me last week was Optima Bank. And it's a simple one-page form, which when you're done, you can send it down to Dan and he can look at it, see if we need to update anything or make any edits. Their deadline is May 31st for decisions by June 15th, which would give us 10 days before the program starts. So they want that form, and then it says other suggested materials, and this is why I'm asking for the budget, are a history of the event or program, a project budget, samples of collateral or marketing materials, and a current list of board members.
Oh, sorry.
You can take it.
No, I just
So, besides that, we can send this with them as our marketing material, so our flyer. And we can provide committee members, which they want a list of board members,
mm-hmm.
so committee members. I don't know, but that's up to the bank. And they have not disclosed an amount on how much they would give. They are based in Portsmouth, so we're right in their range, and they just opened up at Weeks Crossing.
Yeah, that's great.
So, along with the history of the program, So Eastern Bank has a $500 grant, and that's the one I had emailed you about. I started an application for them, and then realized I put the wrong contact people on. I put the board chair, and it should be the select board, because they're the ones that have the final say over our funds.
Okay.
So I have tried to contact Eastern Bank, and they have not gotten back to me about redoing it, so I think I'm going to just see if I can abandon that application.
So that is right there?
This is what, this is some of their...
So you're going to abandon it, so...
I'm going to just start a new application.
Okay.
For Eastern Bank. And so this is a printout of what I had already started for them. Some of it is their examples, and some of it I have filled in. Because I put in the wrong person, I didn't present it to the select board. And here they ask for a history, a brief description or history of our organization. So I started to write one, and maybe you guys want to look it over.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what the bottom thing is, and feel free to edit it. I started that application and then put it on hold until I figured out information from them. But if we came up with a history that we wanted to use, we could use it both for Eastern Bank and Alpha.
What were some of the other items that you were thinking about? Nets for the soccer goals?
Bases for the baseball.
Okay.
Different balls, a volleyball net or a racquetball net.
I'm just putting that in. I took some of what you had here and just sort of wrote something else that you could, you know, fill in the two together if you wanted.
I don't know if we want how we stamp on like baseball equipment, whether we have softball or baseball gloves and stuff.
Yeah, not a lot.
If we want to
right.
include
that. Would be great to use that field. And I don't know. I mean, even just wiffle ball, you know, I don't know how much of that they did.
Yeah.
I would love to see that more organized kind of sporting activities just kind of built in, you know, and they have that field right there and the basketball hoops. Kind of crazy not to be using
yeah. And I believe we can use the basketballs that the school has.
Yeah, yeah. I think so. I think they did last year.
But like outside equipment that they can play with outside.
Right. Yeah. Because those balls shouldn't be used outside. The ones in the school. I know that Mr. Franks gets a little ornery if kids bring them outside, which I understand.
And like I was thinking, maybe even for like the baseball, getting a set of anchored bases that they could keep there,
mm-hmm.
and then getting a set of portable ones that are mm-hmm. just that they could take with them.
Yeah. So I can just add in some of these things.
And then like the teen camp has tennis and volleyball, so even tennis rackets or
mm-hmm.
something, for so that the kids don't have to provide their own.
Do you know where they're going to play tennis? Or
they might be going to Barwick Academy.
Oh, really? Oh, cool.
That's not far.
Who's playing tennis?
The teen camp.
Where do we stand with the teen camp? How many people have registered for that?
I don't even know. Jody usually keeps track of the numbers, and she's not here, so I'm not really sure. And I honestly, she sent me a text around noon time, and I haven't had a chance to even look myself. So,
well, yeah,
sorry.
Because last time we talked, I think there were only a couple people, right?
So there's, since the last time we talked, there haven't been many registrations at all. I've gotten 3 paper registrations, which
for
is good.
Teen camp.
No.
Oh, just in general. Oh.
Yeah, just the summer the Camp Raleigh.
So it's still
the teen camp,
here.
I'm not sure that we've had any, if any at all. So I'll need to go and look, honestly.
Did we talk about a limit or a minimum that we could to actually run that program?
So that's something that Kelly and Jody both have to
Kelly's kind of, that's more her brainchild.
In December, we based it on getting a minimum of 10 kids per week.
Okay.
We meet, I think it was between 1,200 and 1,500 to cover the staff and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
So a minimum of 10 per week to cover staffing?
I don't know if it has to be 10 per week, but we looked at the cost based on 10 and cost based on 15.
Mm-hmm.
I know Jody sent out earlier, might have been yesterday or the day before, a number, like a tuition. How much money registrations we've received, and it doesn't sound like it's budged much in the last month or so.
Mm-hmm.
Along the same lines, do you know if any staffing changes have occurred to the team camp?
None. None I'm aware of.
I'm going to finish this first. So, as you guys are all writing, I hope you can listen at the same time.
I don't know.
So, I went before the select board, and Walmart offers a grant. And they offer eligible nonprofit organizations that operate on the local level and directly benefit their service area. But they do like,
I have some more comments on that, but
and it doesn't want to do the next page, I think.
It does.
I think I have it. Walmart will give grants to local. This one can be edited slightly, but this is the format Walmart wants any letters to come in. They will give to a municipality if the governing body okays it. The select board didn't want to sign it last week until they had more information and verified we were eligible for the programs.
Okay. So how do we find out if we're eligible for the programs?
So for community grants, Walmart gives out a minimum of $250 and a max of $5,000. It's an online application. Anytime between February 1st and December 31st, they remain active for 90 days and we can submit up to 25 applications.
Wow.
And any recognized government agency, state, county, or city agency, including law enforcement or fire departments that are requesting funds exclusively for public purposes. So I figured we would fall under that. And then they have 8 areas of funding, and the 3 that I thought we would fall into, the select board were not sure that they agreed. That's the point of contention right now. One would be quality of life, improving access to recreation, arts, or cultural experiences for low-income individuals and families in the United States, or community and economic development, improving local communities for the benefit of individuals with low incomes or individuals, families and individuals in the United States. And then the 3rd one was diversity and inclusion, fostering the building of relationships and understanding among diverse groups in the United States.
I have to agree with the select board. I don't know if we fall under any of those.
So the first 2, they were concerned that we're not serving enough low-income families.
That's right. Yeah.
And that most of our funds come from tuition. So they did not agree with that. Since we do not provide food, we do not, since we do not provide a meal program, we do not fall under the healthy relief and eating program, hunger relief and healthy eating program. We do not provide social services, so we do not fall under the health and human service ones. There's an education one, which provides after-school enrichment tutoring or vocational for low and income families, which we wouldn't qualify if we don't qualify for the other ones.
Mm-hmm.
Public safety, which would be supporting public safety programs or trainings in the United States, or equipment for those programs, and then environmental stability, which would be recycling, wastewater, and so forth. So those are their eight categories. The one that the select board said that they would feel comfortable with us applying for underneath would be diversity and inclusion if we had a specific program in which we were providing diversity and inclusion format or presentations. And the only thing I could think of was last year Kelly brought us the flyer for the guy who did bike tricks and talked about bullying. So I don't know if we want to continue with the Walmart or if we just want to let it be. The select board said maybe we take that letter instead to the local store and they could give us a grant up to, or a gift card up to $250.
I would probably, yeah, I don't know about this, about the grant. I mean, I wish there was some way we could squeeze ourselves in there. I just would feel awkward about trying to create something to get.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Because right now, as far as I know with what Brittany and Janessa are planning, as far as programs, I can't think of anything there that's could be considered diversity and inclusion. That's all I hear about at work. Diversity and inclusion.
So
yeah, maybe we should just go the route of going to the store instead.
Okay. It would be a lesser amount, but it would give us something for this year. And their other concern was from the select board that I got the other night,
mm-hmm.
was making sure that we send letters and photos to the grant that we're getting so that they know that we're using the money for their designated purpose and that
okay.
it doesn't go back to the town at the end of the year as a general fund if we are profitable. Like they want to make sure that the money just doesn't go back.
Okay.
So they want...
All right, so are we okay to send them photos? I know there's always an issue about photos. Okay, because I know
well,
for marketing purposes, it's fine.
I think what I did last year was like when I went to Target and I got the $50 gift card, I went and I did the shopping and then I brought it back to the camp and they did all that on their table and I took pictures of all the goods.
Okay.
And it wasn't any kids. So then I was able to include it with the thank you card.
Okay.
That we gave Target, but like Mark and but like C&J requested pictures for their marketing purposes, which brings up a question that I had in one of those emails was that we took the kids last year on a field trip to the Wentworth House, and I went over during that afternoon and took a bunch of pictures and uploaded them to the drive. So we have pictures of the kids at the Wentworth House. The Wentworth House put out, their new webmaster put out a call for kids on the field trips and wanted to know if anybody, any parents had pictures or anything. Do we want to, and that would be marketing for the Wentworth House, it's not us, it's them.
So we have in the handbook that it's, if it's specific for our purposes for the town of Rollinsford, then we can do it, but if it's specifically for Wentworth, it's a different story.
So I have not sent any pictures. I just didn't know where to go. My concern is it okay? Is it not okay?
Yeah, because we go back and forth about this all the time, the photos.
So.
Because it would be nice to be able to partner with them, you know, because we did, the kids did have a good time. And I don't know who we should ask about that. Let's see if we
Who headed up the picture issue last year, the photo issue, do you know, do you remember?
I know Jody had some concerns over it because people were there the first day, community members were there the first day, taking pictures, and they don't have any kids in there, and they posted them to social media. And it was the community doesn't know who has photo access and who doesn't. And I sent an email to Brittany and the other directors last year saying, could you please review these and make sure that all of them have photo releases? And that was a question brought before the select board. Can we, that other agencies might want to use pictures for their own marketing. Is it okay for us to forward pictures to other agencies for marketing? And I don't know.
Well, I don't know if it happened with me, but again, I think because we did the photo releases specific to the town of Wallingford marketing, I think based on that, we probably wouldn't be able to. I'm not sure if I have it with me. Yeah, that's the town and rec department publications. Well, I could easily ask somebody. Let me see, who can I ask? Let me think on that one. Let me see who I can ask about that.
That's okay. So, talking about that, do you know, and I was hoping Brittany would be here, the Wentworth House, if we are planning to go there again, would like to plan it earlier in the season, so they would like to be involved now.
Okay.
So, if we'd like to go there, we need to get her in contact with them.
Let me ask her.
I don't know if it was enjoyable for the kids or not.
Okay. To the Wentworth. I am the world's worst texter.
And if so, I will put her in touch with the person who wants that.
Okay. See if she gets back to us. Okay, so I will ask somebody. I'll find out. We should get this all sorted out anyways again this year, the whole photo issue. So let me see who I can ask about that. And the select board wants photos for whomever submits a grant.
Yes.
Okay.
Well, they want to make sure that whoever gets a grant gets photos.
Yes.
So, or that they know their funds went to X, Y, and Z, not to the general.
Yeah, makes sense.
So I was also out selling calendars and stopped by Kristen Palenko, who helped us with the shirts last year.
Mm-hmm.
She wanted me to remind the committee that the shirt order needs to be in by May 17th.
Okay.
And it is, we are on a tight schedule for getting shirts. So if...
So I know what we have left over. We'll have to compare it against what we've gotten for registrations now.
Yeah. And what I did last year.
Are we giving everybody new shirts regardless?
Yes.
Okay.
And it's one shirt per child at no charge. And then
the second one is
an additional shirt per child is a charge. But each family, if you have three kids in Camp Raleigh, you get three shirts. If you have two kids in Camp Raleigh, you get two free shirts. And then if you want to buy extra shirts for your kids, then they come in at $7.
Wait, I'm confused.
Every child gets a shirt. Last year, we did
it
by family.
You want extra shirts?
Oh, you did it by, that's right. Okay.
So your first shirt was free per family.
Mm-hmm.
But if you registered two kids, then you had to pay for your second.
But this year, everything gets one shirt for the charge of the...
Yeah, it's all inclusive.
But then we are planning on having...
last year a couple of families decided they wanted an extra shirt so that they, if one got dirty on a field trip, they would have an extra one and they didn't have to
and
rush
they're
around
only the wearing the shirts on the field trips.
Yes.
Right? Yeah.
So that's for Camp Raleigh. They get, and Brittany should be hopefully covering this, but she needs to make sure that she has, I added in 3 to 5 shirts of every size last year extra to account for the registrations that we didn't have. So ordering extra shirts. So that we would have them. We did not use the adult sizes, from my knowledge.
And there's a ton of them left.
So maybe just going with the kid sizes, extras, because
we're getting the exact same shirts, the same color, the same logo and everything. So
for the kids in Camp Raleigh. Mm. And so by May 17th, she needs, the staff shirts need to be decided. Are they getting tank tops? Are they getting...
Yeah, I think Brittany was doing that on her own.
Right.
Like, she wasn't going to order them.
Okay.
I think.
Are they going to have the Camp Raleigh emblem on them? Are they going to be plain? Are they going to say staff? Because if they need... Are they... If they're going to be a different color, then somebody else should probably... Like, Kristen needs to be involved, or the printer needs to be involved to make sure that they'll show up. And they need to, it may be an extra charge to the committee because they have to create a new screen if they're putting something new on them. If that makes sense.
Mm.
And then your third issue, also regarding shirts that probably needs to go to Brittany right now, is the teen camp. I believe we said we were giving them shirts. I don't know how many, but I believe we said more than one because they're going on field trips every day. Now, are they going to be just plain shirts, or are they going to say like Rollinsford on them? Are they going to say team,
mm-hmm.
camp? Or are we going to go with the shirts through the printer and see if he can get us a better deal? Or are we going to go to like CVS or Rite Aid where they had Rollinsford, New Hampshire shirts? For $5.
I know at one time, it might have been the last meeting, she was talking about getting shirts and then tie-dyeing them, like having them all do their own shirts. I can check in with her on that. So, oh, she is going to the Wentworth house.
Okay. So, I can put it on my list too. I will email her the contact information of the Wentworth house. Well, I was just asked to remind the committee about the deadline and that there may be an extra charge if we are adding anything in for the teen camp or the staff shirts. So, and I do know that Brittany had been talking through the printer about shirts, so
okay.
I'm hoping that she's got all of that covered.
Shirts.
Because the Wentworth House, although they enjoyed our visit last year, felt a little rushed and ill-prepared. And we went back and forth with numbers. So I'm sure they're going to want numbers. And they were very nice to us. I think they did a presentation for 25 kids for $100. And they provided all of the materials for butter making. They did cloth printing and a couple other things.
I think it cost them more to do that, didn't it?
Yeah, I think they lost money. They had somebody outside doing game, old-time games, and then they felt like they were scrambling for volunteers because we got to them so late with a date and that time.
So she said, as far as the shirts are concerned, she's reached out to the guy who did them last year. And she's waiting back on some information.
The request was just that if we're going to make changes or we have to do the screen printing, to know that there's an extra charge and that everything has to be in May 17th to get it in time. And she can talk to Chris too if she needs any assistance. Now, my understanding is that Brittany is going to coordinate with Kristen and the printer to make sure that everything's all right, like all the shirts are up to par, everything that we want.
Okay.
That's what I have. Oh, the calendars, if you, they went home, they're due back at school tomorrow.
Yeah, they are.
So I had requested extra ones, and they came home the Friday before vacation. I put an email out.
I see one of those.
And I didn't hear back from anybody, so I ended up with 30 calendars because nobody on the committee said they wanted any extras. So I've done my due diligence to sell my 10 as requested in the letter that came home from the school.
Each child was to sell 10?
It was requested, but not mandated.
Uh-huh.
And then the rec committee was, so we were supposed to be selling them too, as we could, to outside people.
A MasterCard only gave 24, not 25.
Maybe it's a typo.
Seems
oh,
kind of
yeah,
strange.
That's weird. Yeah.
Where is
that one?
28th of May.
Yeah. I also noticed that there are 31 days in May and only 30 days. And I mean.
So this was the PTO's thing, but we kind of jumped onto it.
It was our idea.
It was our idea.
The PTO took it on, and they are going to give a donation to Camp Raleigh.
Okay, so some percentage of what they bring in from this is going to go towards Camp Raleigh.
So, yeah. They're going to save a portion for what they need to do, and we're going to get a portion, and they'll make it the following donation.
What about C&J? Have we heard back?
No.
Was Kelly taking that? Did she
I
take
had
the responsibility
it, but I was going to ask her tonight if she wanted to take it on. I can reach out again.
Reach out to her.
I'll reach out to both of them. I'll write an email to C&J and carbon copy Kelly, and hopefully she knows somebody there. Maybe.
Okay.
Yeah. That's all I have.
Okay. I virtually have nothing, honestly. Not now.
Do you have anything?
No. We just covered grants.
Yeah.
She covered off some grants that are being pursued right now.
So just going back to the registration, it's the deadline is the 31st of May, or is it June 15th? It says registration closes June 15th. Tuition must be paid by May 31st. On the front page of the one. Maybe this was an earlier version of it. I don't know.
So the paper version, everything needs to be paid by, paid in full by May 31st, and registration closes June 15th. So that makes no sense.
Yeah, that's all right.
Too late.
I'm too late on that. Yeah.
Now it's something that we.
So what? Which date is the? Because I mean, camp starts. Oh, that's right, because the kids have a week between school ending and then the camp.
Yeah, so it's June 25th. So we're encouraging registrations to close June 15th.
Right.
And that'll give us 10 days if we need to adjust staff.
Mm-hmm. So the May 31st is not really it's more of June 15th is more of the hard deadline.
June 15th is more of the hard.
Yeah.
A hard day, for sure.
Do you recall last year, did things seem to roll in, getting closer to that date, yeah.
Yeah, we picked up the pace for sure.
Yeah. It's still, you know, still some time.
That reminds me, we had stated at one of our earlier meetings that we would discuss scholarships again come later spring. Do we want to table that until the next meeting?
Let's table that.
Getting out.
How many people used the scholarships last year?
Last year we had enough for two, and this year we've already gotten three in.
Now, what were the three that you, I don't have my list here, you'd sent me the list, I just don't, I didn't have it with me. Do you remember?
You mean we have three kids who need it, or three?
We have not announced, we have not put it in.
We have funding for three kids.
We have funding for three. And they came from the Police Benevolence Association, the St. Mary's Church Ladies Guild, and the American Legion Auxiliary.
And this is for the entirety of Camp Raleigh?
They both came in at, all three of them came in at 330, based on this flyer.
Which is all, the whole, all 8 weeks.
For Camp Raleigh. And so.
So I think Jody was gonna take the responsibility for that again, because she's the one who has, she's more educated on what needs to happen.
Right, and she's dealt with it before in her field of work, I guess is the way to put it. So, last year we had two kids apply last, we didn't announce it until the end of May, but we had scholarships, and we had two families apply, and that's what we had scholarships for. This year we have an extra scholarship, but and the town has asked us to make sure that we take care of it, because the auditor didn't flag it necessarily, but was concerned that we have no way of tracking scholarships and who gets them, and we have no way. Once the money is given for scholarships, it's a designated purpose and it has to go to that.
But what do they mean by, I can ask Caroline, but what do they mean by tracking?
Ensuring that it doesn't get just put into the general fund.
And it's actually going to the families.
It's actually being used for scholarship. And if we're not giving out the family's name, verifying that the designated funds are being used for that.
So if I'm talking about our own internal budget being used, we can have a different line item, which you do, but if they wanted to keep it completely separate, that's something that Caroline, I think, needs to do in her own accounting system, is to make it, you know, because you've got codes and all that for everything, so she would need to make a different code specific for scholarships.
So that Caroline and the select board are supposed to be, and the auditor, are supposed to be working together for scholarship funds and creating some stuff. We have... There was an email that went out in March about what our practice is for scholarships, what our level is, and how it's determined whether or not you are eligible. But it's not been reviewed and put into policy by the select board, if that makes sense. And the main concern of the auditor is because it's given to the town for scholarship purposes is to ensure that it gets used for that, and if we have extra funds, that it gets put aside for another year. And how do we go about doing that, that it's a designated fund for that purpose only? So if we go over, if we don't get enough, then how do we carry it over to the next year instead of letting it go back into the general fund? Or if we go over, if more applicants come in, how do we account for giving partial scholarships based on different levels of need?
Okay.
So Caroline is supposed to be working with the auditor, coming up with some stuff.
All right, so I'll just ask her how she's handling that, or how she anticipates handling that, so we know. If there's anything different that we need to do.
Yeah, and if you need to, let me know, and I can give you what our... what we voted on in our meetings as our practice.
Okay. Yes?
That's all I have.
Yeah, that's really all I have. I'm sorry.
Sorry.
Oh, we do have to set the next meeting, though.
daily activities, and she's going to give us a list of what she needs for donations. Is that correct?
I don't. But she said she sent out something that said what she wanted, and she said she sent out a list of a couple things that she wanted, but she said she's going to send something out with what she wants for arts and crafts materials.
Okay.
But I do know on her list that her and Janessa came up with was lots and lots of water balloons.
Oh.
Fun. So I'm thinking that instead of this year getting water, which we ended up with a lot of leftover water that last year, if we get gift cards to grocery stores and Target and Walmart, getting as many water balloons as I can.
Yeah.
And then I got her last year a pool to put them in, so maybe getting another pool so they can have like a water balloon fight.
Yeah.
And they can have different like pools filled with water.
Yeah.
And I know last year she had asked for sponges and stuff like that. And I was thinking at the grocery stores, instead of doing waters, maybe doing freeze pops too, so that, or other snacks that she would want. So maybe we need to ask her about snacks or grocery store items. Because,
you know what we should do is, I guess first of all, so Mother's Day is the 13th. So what about the 20th, May 20th? And I can ask her if she can give us a list maybe before then,
yeah,
if possible, so we can start like planning and picking away at it.
Because
is May 20th good for you?
Yeah, sounds good.
Okay.
Same time, same.
Same bat channel?
Yep.
They request either an employee be on your board or an employee verify that they know people who participate in the program, or somebody at the store can vouch for you. They won't. So you either have to go in and talk to the store manager at your local store,
mm-hmm,
or know somebody who works there.
Oh.
To get a donation. Because they call the store to get a heads up on the different organizations they donate to.
Oh, okay.
Huh.
And I actually know somebody that works at Shaw's.
Oh,
oh,
good.
Nice.
Nice.
Yeah, yeah.
So.
That's very good.
Wonderful.
You're doing some great work.
So I'm hoping. And the select board did ask, and this is the plan, that these grants help us close the gap in what we are planning to do with the summer camp and our shortfall in our budget, if that makes sense.
Mm-hmm.
So the town doesn't have to give as much money to cover us.
Yes. What I'm going to ask. What about t-shirts? Have we had any t-shirt sales?
We had somebody email us, and that was it. And even when I put this out on Facebook, only one person from the community responded. And so I ran over this weekend and got one person who's, and like I had talked to somebody else who responded to my email or to my Facebook post and bought two calendars, but I had asked them prior. So,
okay.
But that's me. I don't know how to make a pin post. And it wasn't coming directly from the rec committee either. So.
Okay. I'll get on Facebook and see if I can't push t-shirts again.
Yeah.
Okay. Awesome. All right, so May 20th. I can't think if there's anything else I was going to ask you about.
Are we going to meet here, or are we going to leave that up in the air?
Let's leave it up in the air right now. It's going to depend if Denise is here for him, he's gonna do it.
I have the keys.
Yes, he does. So, I'll get with Denise and Vern usually videotapes for us, so we can also. Sound good? Okay, motion to adjourn, 8:48?
7:48?
7.
Is it, it's, ooh.
7.
I'd be late making this, I'd be late.